अस्सलाम वालेकुम, हाउ आर यू स्टूडेंट्स? इट इज़ मिसेस तल्लत खुशनूद एंड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर सेकेंड चैप्टर यूजिंग द साइंटिफिक मेथड्स. यूजिंग द साइंटिफिक मेथड्स एज इट इज़ रिटन बाय डैरल बर्नर्ड एंड लॉन एडवर्ड इन इट्स अ कोलैबोरेटिव वर्क इंडीड. And this essay discusses the benefits of scientific method. It is the use of science in modern ways that has resulted in progress of all kinds. So, look at the title of the essay first. As you know, using the scientific method means impartial observation of the facts that helps the observer in finding out general laws about other facts of the same kind. Okay students, let's start with the chapter. Look at the first paragraph of it. All of us have benefited greatly from the use of scientific method in solving problems such as those dealing with the maintenance of health, production and preservation of foods, the construction of our homes. Basically, these three are the basis of the human life. Maintenance of health, the first thing, first and the foremost thing. The production and preservation of the foods, that is very important with the human life. And construction of homes, obviously equally important for all. Improvement in communication and transportation. Not only have all our ways of living changed, but people themselves have also been changed. Today, they are better able to explain happenings which used to be considered strange and mysterious. Although there is still need for improvement, and we are now generally less fearful than our forefathers and grandfathers were, we are also more critical in our thinking than our ancestors. I hope you are understanding all these facts that are given in this paragraph. The lesson should help you understand how the use of scientific method has improved living conditions and changed people. It should also help you understand how you can make better use of scientific method in your everyday life. So let's have a look at the three main contents that the writers wants to discuss with their readers about the changes in the lives of the people of today, and at the same time they are comparing it with the past. Better control of disease. Look at the title. Better control of disease. It means that what the changes that have taken place in our health maintenance conditions. The writer says, if you had been born just 200 years ago, you would have had about one chance in eight of living to be 1 year old. Very dangerous thing. Look at it. It means that only 100 years ago, only one out of eight children could survive. In other words, in those days, about seven out of eight babies died before reaching their first birthday. Suppose you had been an unusually strong fellow and had lived through your first year, very likely before you are 6 years old, you would have had smallpox, and by that time you reach the age of 12, you would undoubtedly have the measles, whooping cough, scarlet fever, diphtheria. These are the different sort of diseases that were very common only a few years or a few hundred years ago. Even then, your battle for the life was not over. Yellow fever, malaria, typhus, cholera, typhoid fever, and even influenza once started spread through the community. Life was most uncertain. A person who could live more than 30 years of age was indeed fortunate. This is unbelievable that such condition should have existed so short a time ago. today babies are born. Let's have a look at now, look at the fact that how the conditions have been changed now. Now the babies are born in the hospitals where there is a little likelihood of getting some disease. Young people are treated to protect them against smallpox, diphtheria, typhoid fever. These are all the very, very dangerous sort of diseases that caused deaths in the history. Today, a person can expect to live to be almost 70 years old, and it is very interesting things to look at that almost 30 years are added to the human life. These changes have been made possible by use of scientific methods to solve such problems, such as the causes of disease and preservation and its prevention. Yes, students, let's have a look at the words that can have different meanings, other meanings with it in this paragraph that we have read. Benefited means took advantage of, to have benefit out of something. Preservation means keeping in fine condition, to preserve something for the future. Communication means ways to travel. Transportation means sending by vehicles. Mysterious means a thing which is ununderstandable for the common people. Critical, fault finding, and ancestors, forefathers. Now let's continue with the better sanitary conditions. Look at the first paragraph. It is difficult to maintain, it's difficult to imagine what sanitary conditions in some of our larger cities were like only 100 years ago. Now let's try to find out the meaning of sanitary first. Sanitary means hygienic, keeping clean and germ free. And it is about the mainly about the water supply conditions and to disposal of the used water. It is difficult to imagine that sanitary conditions in some of our larger cities were like only 100 years ago. Into the narrow, unpaved and poorly drained city streets, household garbage and other refuse were thrown. Unpaved, having no pavement, poorly drained, there was no drainage system for the household garbage and other refuses of the homes. Animals wandered through the streets, feeding upon the garbage into wells from which the people obtained drinking water. Such a horrible condition it was. But look at the conditions nowadays. Today, by using the scientific methods, how the conditions have been changed. The city streets of today are paved and well drained, and they are cleaned regularly. It is against the law to throw garbage in the streets. Sewage from all sections of the cities through the sealed pipes to disposable plants. Through the use of the scientific method, it has been demonstrated that it have been observed that unsanitary conditions cause the spread of diseases like typhoid fever, cholera and dysentery. Today, most city governments have departments of sanitation which keep the cities clean and thereby prevent the spread of certain diseases. Now look at the three more diseases: typhoid fever, cholera, dysentery. These are also some sort of diseases that are related to the stomach.